Right, folks, hope everyone's sound. So, got the new dinghy in today. We've just bought an Aqua Parks 330 Mark III Pro. And yeah, we're just opening it up now. Say hi, Lana Lou.
Hello.
So we've kind of had a little tea into it already. We've just taken off the tape, haven't we, Lana? So it looks like we've got some extras coming for this. We do have the air floor coming. It should be here on Friday, so 2 days' time it should come in. This looks like the seats. Also ordered a seat bag with some padding as well. So this is what we're getting. So I believe these seats slide. They're adjustable along the sort of length of the dinghy. Yeah, we can move this ones around, Lana. And we don't have to have two, of course. We could just have one if we want, I guess. Paddles, just in case. We've got a fairly good, reliable outboard, but it's only a four horse. What have we got here, Dimples? Patches and a key for the valves. And some glue and an instruction manual. Owner's manual. There we go. A foot pump, free with it. We've got a 12 volt electric pump. It's not the most powerful, but it does make pumping it up a little bit easier on you on a hot day, where at least you're not having to go all the time. I was hoping this came with a bag. I think we're gonna have to buy a bag for this, Lana.
Maybe there's one underneath.
Possibly. We'll have to put the camera down to pull it out of there, aren't we? There we go. Nah, there's no bag. I think it just comes like it is. We're going to have to buy a bag separately. Okay, though, that's fine. Let's see if I can slide it out of here. Preferably without ripping the box.
It's huge.
It's all sort of stuck together. It's huge compared to our other one for sure, isn't it?
What's bigger? Oh. I didn't think it would be that much bigger.
It's a brute to pull you around.
It just fits in here.
So that's all pumped up. It's a giant Dimples. The other little tender I have is a little XM 2.3. It was old my old tender from a trailer sailor from a little sailboat. So this is a meter bigger. It'll take a bigger. I'll see how I get on with the air floor. If I don't like it, I'll invest in an aluminium floor for it. But yeah, we'll get a bit of fun in this. Bit of spearfishing, bit of fishing and touring around Findhorn.
Like, folks. So we're down at the Crudens in Findhorn today. Myself and youngest daughter planning a bit of spearfishing tomorrow. My other daughter and my wife are away at a concert, so I've got a deck light set up here, GoPro camera, dive flag. There is a mount on the back here for an all-round white light. I've got a battery under the seat here, as well as flares and a first aid kit and a few other bits and bobs. Compass on there. Fuel, anchor, chain and warp, and our lunch, basically. And I've got a knife and a couple of waterproof boxes screwed in underneath this seat. Here the geese here coming overhead. So we're heading over to the Black Shed, heading over to the Culbin there. And yeah, we'll see how this handles. I also, don't know if you can see that, I made up a bracket for that pole. I wasn't that keen in and actually screwing into the transom on a new boat.
Sand fields are where they're taken. Cairns, Peaky Dars, that I want up. So speed wise, we're probably only getting maybe, I don't know, 5 knots, 5.5 knots, something like that. So I've still got a little bit to do to carry this dinghy. Got a handheld Garmin GPS and a depth sounder still to fit the bracket to hold my GoPro camera and dive flag on the other side of that. I'll be able to put the transducer for a depth sounder, a GPS bracket for that real blaze of mine. I'll pretty much be set, I think. Maybe another rod holder. Probably got the one rod holder. It'd be nice to have another one, even something something to secure the spear gun to as well when I'm bouncing around. So.
She's not got a diving suit today, so just a surfing wetsuit. I wish she still had the mask on and been getting calm.
Yeah.
So obviously we're back at the block shed again. You've seen this before if you look back in one of my previous videos. My grandpa used to keep a boat in here. Over on the Culbin.
See the tower there, you see forests. Off in the background.
From Loss. And Findhorn. That tide's fairly starting to drop now. See the line of wet stones as the water's receding out the bay. Alright, Lana Lou's going to take us back over. Take a run past Elvin Point first.
There's a better look at my bracket. Put the transducer on the back there. I've got my waterproof boxes underneath. I've also got a knife. Not the greatest when you've got an inflatable floor, but important to have a sharp knife. I made that handle up myself. It was the first knife I ever made.
Right, life jacket back on and we'll get back over to Findhorn. That's fast as she goes.
No.
Let's see your legs, are you gonna find? Go, go, go!
So just before we put everything away and get finished up, just wanted to show you another rail blazer port there. Still got a few extras to come in for the rail blazer stuff, but I've got an arm there that'll go down with a mount for it to sit my depth sounder on. Couple other bits to keep in here, first aid kit. And some flares, probably overkill, but I do plan to go a couple of miles off at times, so handy to have. Battery pack here, this works my all-round white light. My anchor light, which I have there, it goes onto that bracket that I showed you earlier on the pole. And yeah, I've got a couple of USB ports and two cigarette lighter adapters there. It's just a 7 amp hour 12 volt battery, nothing overly fancy, but yeah, it should do the trick. So that's pretty much it so far. I've still got another couple of rod holders and little bits and bobs to do, but that's more or less it, guys.
Thingy's all folded up, put away. Bonnie day down here. I love being in Findhorn.
Well, like, folks, thanks for making it this far. I really do appreciate you all
Subscribe if you haven't done already, like and comment, it really does help me out. I'm sorry about this bumpy road, I'm back out onto the river tonight for a patrol this evening. I've managed to get myself a little 15 horse Mariner two-stroke engine for the little SIB, so we've got a little bit more horsepower for next time, which will make a difference. It can be a six-knot tide there at Findern Bay, certainly, so nice to have a little bit more power. We're a little bit undergunned, and now we're at sort of max. It's rated for a 15 horse. Quite a difference in the weight between the two-stroke and four-stroke versions, about 10 kilos weight difference, which is significant on a little boat. So we'll see you all next time, and until then, as always, smile at strangers, show your loved ones they're loved, and use the force.